everyone, it's Tammy, and it's time to do our monthly Dollar Tree craft. So, oh, I have that for something else. Ooh, I almost lost my wrapping paper. So, I'm going to get out a frame and a little deer. And if you guys recall, this is some wrapping paper that I used last year. And ooh, it's big enough to go this way and that way. Cool. So I won't have to use all of it, or very much of it even. So let me cut this so that it'll fit the frame. And I might have to cut it some more, but that's okay. I'll just get this big part out of the way. All right. So what you need is just a frame from the Dollar Tree. This is super cheapo dollar frame. And I have some hot glue and I have that wrapping paper and I have an ornament. And the ornament that I chose is a 3D ornament. So I'm just going to open up this frame. I was thinking, I wasn't even sure if that was glass or plastic, but it is glass. And I'm going to use this so that I can cut my plaid paper to the same size. And it should be at 8.5 by 11, but you never know. So let me just double check this. Oh, an 8 by 10 I meant, dingbat. So it's almost 10 and almost 8. That's funny. So I guess I need to pull out my little arm, don't I? And I need to do almost 8 on this side. And actually, I think I'm just going to make this straight. I can remember which side is actually straight. Actually, this looks straight, so let me do this in first. So I need it to be almost 10. So I think what I'll do, oh, it might even just be that already. Oh, yes, it is. And almost 8. It might fit this bill just like it is. Let me try that first. I might not need to cut it at all. Okay, I guess I can trim it just a hair on this side. And then I will trim it a little bit on this side. And let's try that again. All right, that fits. So now I'm just gonna put this down. And then this down. Oops, I think this is backwards. Yes, because the hook is out here. All right. So that's cute already, isn't it? And then what we're going to do is take this ornament. Now you can pick any ornament that you want, obviously. I chose this deer because I thought he was really cute. And I'm going to cut off his tag, and he separates. You can break him in two very easily. And then I am just going to hot glue him onto this frame so that I can have like a 3D frame hanging. I think that sounds really cute. Or you could even do two if you wanted to. You could even make them kissing. Oh, is that cute? I think I'm going to do that. I think that's kind of cute. And I wonder, should I do it this way? I think I will. So I'm just going to take my hot glue, and I'm noticing where he kind of fits, and it's along here. So I'm just going to, if I can, if my hot glue will come out. Jiminy Christmas. Here it comes. Actually, you can kind of see where the hot glue was on it, or supposed to be on it, or where it would touch the base. And after I put it on there, I'm just going to stick them right there on the glass. So this cost $1 for the ornament and $1 for the frame. And I already had the wrapping paper. You could also use a piece of scrapbook paper if you didn't have wrapping paper. Want to make sure that it'll stick. And I guess it will. It's actually pretty stuck. Goodness, this isn't as easy to stick it as I thought it might be. It shouldn't be this difficult. Here we go. I think my glue wasn't quite warm enough, and it's better now. There we go. So that's the whole craft. Isn't that cute? You can use this as a decoration on your wall. It's just very pretty and festive and very inexpensive. And I think it's an awesome craft. You could even do something like this and give it as a gift. Maybe if you know an engaged couple or something like that, that might be cute. I just think it's adorable. It makes me think of me and Dennis. And if you wanted to, you could even put... And let's do that. You can even put a little bit of stickles on one of their noses to make him Rudolph. And then I'll let that dry, of course. So now it's like Rudolph and I think her name is Clarissa or something like that. Clarice! So there we go. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.